Hello everyone, welcome to my channel. In today's tutorial, I have chosen a rose for you. I find this flower very beautiful, the colors, the shape, the fragrance, all very appealing. So I thought it would be a nice topic for today's tutorial. So without further delay, let's begin. Now I spent some time on the sketch, and since that is the main subject, I took up most of my canvas space for the rose. I also feel drawing a rose is easier compared to other flowers because the petals all look so different, some curled up, some open, some big, some small, so one can take more liberties while drawing them. After completing the drawing, I start my painting. You can see the color list on the screen. I mix my scarlet lake and white to make a pink tint and start from the innermost petals. Now you would see me blending between these colors. Our rose petal has a soft texture, so we need to aim for a perfect blend. And the technique each time that I use is to use a medium consistency paint, a dry brush, and short strokes. I also make sure that the strokes are light. And what I mean is, I do not apply too much pressure while making my short strokes, as it can lift the paint off rather than blend it. Anytime you mix white into a color, you make a lighter version of that color, and that is called a tint. Throughout the painting, you would see me making different tints by mixing white into scarlet lake and vermilion red for different petals. I have used lemon yellow for brightness and permanent yellow medium for warmth. A little bit of Prussian blue also has been introduced at a later stage, which I have mainly mixed with my scarlet lake for a purple shade. Most of the petal tips are light. I have achieved that by adding more white to the tips and pulling a few strokes in to show the fine veins that appear on the petals. The starting points on the petals and the sides of the petals are mostly kept dark. I take one petal at a time and proceed. I do not believe in rushing through the process because time is essential. You need to spend enough time on each petal to get the desired look. So in the age of short form content, I'm putting out something that takes a lot of your screen time. I am taking a huge risk as I do not understand these new age trends. But I wanted to create an honest tutorial for anyone who's seriously pursuing art. Each time you would see me mix grey or white or purple with the other colours to create some different shade or tint, and each petal is treated differently. I would suggest you to please go through the whole tutorial, understand the process and make it your own. The petals on the sides are more of grey shade and it has very less tint of pink or any red. It can be confusing initially, but once the background colors come in and we see it in its totality, we then understand how the shadows are falling on the flower and how certain areas have been highlighted. We can then understand it better. Art is a beautiful journey which needs a little patience. And since I love this journey so much, I don't mind being patient. Now, if you ask me, should we color the background first before the foreground? I personally feel it's totally up to the artist, and since art is free flowing, I feel we shouldn't have too many rigid rules and we should go with what works best with our style. That way we would be our authentic self always. The leaves have been painted in sap green and light green and a tinge of red, vermilion red. I've tried to give highlights on the leaves with white and lemon yellow. Most of the leaves in the background have just been dabbed with a dry brush. With this tutorial, I hope you had as much fun as I had. I had a lot of fun painting a subject that I really enjoy. If you have any suggestions or feedback, please do let me know in the comment section. And if you like my content, please do share, like, and subscribe. Thank you so much for your time.